that the Lord of all the earth will care to know my name, will care to feel my hurt. Who am I that the bright morning star would choose to light the way for my ever wandering heart? It's not because of who I am, but because of what you've done. It's not because of what I've done, but because of who you are. I am a flower quickly fading, here today and gone tomorrow. A wave tossed in the ocean, a vapor in the wind. Still you hear me when I'm calling, Lord, you catch me when I'm falling. And you told me who I am. I'm yours. I'm yours. If you believe you belong to Jesus, let me see you wave your hands. Who am I that the eyes that sees my sins will look at me with love and watch me rise again? Who am I that the voice that calms the sea will call out through the rain and calm the storm in me? It's not because of who I am, but because of what you've done. Not because of what I've done, but because of who you are. I am a flower, quickly fading, a wave tossed in the ocean. I'm a vapor in the wind. Still you hear me when I'm calling, Lord, you catch me when morning. Hey, I am a flower, here today and gone tomorrow. Wave toss in the ocean, I'm a vapor in the wind. Still will hear me, Lord, you catch me when I'm falling. And you told me who I am. Hey, I am a flower, here today and gone. A wave just in the ocean, vapor in the wind. Still will you hear me when I'm calling, Lord, you catch me when and you told me who I am. Oh, I'm yours. I'm yours.
You may be seated. Thank you. Hallelujah. Viewers all over the world, where can we go from His presence? We bless His holy name. Hallelujah. We oftentimes ignore our conscience. We keep talk of Holy Spirit. Where there is nothing bad about that. We ignore our conscience, our heart. But oftentimes, Holy Spirit is good. The same conscience the Holy Spirit used to guide us. The Holy Spirit used our conscience to guide us, to guide your soul. So if Holy Spirit, there will be nothing for Holy Spirit to use. Take note, your conscience, your heart. If your heart is not there for the Holy Spirit, there is nothing the Holy Spirit can do. It cannot reach you. It cannot contact you. So, but all the time, the Holy Spirit, God, Holy Spirit, God, Holy Spirit, Jesus, Holy Spirit, God. But ignore the fundamental. There is no way he could hit you. There is no way he could greet you. There is no way he could reach you. That is very instrument the Holy Spirit used to guide your soul. Tell your neighbor, don't ignore your conscience. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. How do we ignore our conscience? When your is to pray. But you don't know that before you pray, you need to examine yourself. And if you don't examine yourself and you pray, whom are you praying to? Am I really qualified? Am I on to pray? What am I doing? Who I am? Where am I coming from? You examine yourself first. Sometimes you may not even pray. You on that examination. It may be examination you will do and just end there. You may wake up in the morning. When you wake up and look around, ha! You may be on the examination all through. Yes. But today we wake up, we jump up. Jesus, thank you. Jesus, thank you. Yes, good, thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless me, bless me. Who are you praying to? Oftentimes we ignore our conscience. The very instrument used by the Holy Spirit, your heart. You can be on examination and just end the whole thing like that. Without even saying, God, help me. God, help me. Because you know you are not worthy to even ask that. Because you are on the examination, you need to examine yourself. You are not qualified. So you have to be qualified. Tell your neighbor, don't ignore your conscience. Is the very instrument the Holy Spirit himself used to guide us, to hear us. Yes, the very instrument. If you want to enter a forest, you have to make a path. If there's no path and there's a tongue everywhere, you'll be looking for any available row or path you can follow. Until you get that, before you enter the forest, that path is what we call heart. So in order to have effective prayer, there must not be anything between you and God. So this is what we are talking about. That is holding offense, such as anger, bitterness, pain of the past, and so forth. And these are the things that live in our heart. This what we talk about, conscience. This is a place where those things live. This is why many times you continue to pray, you find that you are talking to yourself. Don't ignore your conscience. The book of Romans 9 verse 1 said, our conscience is the communication point. That is contact point. It's what? I can't hear you. That is contact point. If I don't contact this place, I can't get to that place. That is your heart. If God does not contact this place, he can't touch your soul. He can't guide your soul. He can't guide you. Let me put it this way. If God does not contact this heart, he cannot guide you. He cannot talk to you. That is your heart. You can call it your spirit. Heart means spirit of man. So, but we often ignore it. Call Holy Spirit, come down. Holy Spirit, come down. God, come down. Whereas your heart is full of evil, offense, anger. Holy Spirit, come down. Let's assume the Holy Spirit come down. He will just be moving around. He can't near you because a place to contact is deadness. It's deadness. This is why you is able to look upon pain and wrong and injustice toward neighbor unaffected. You look at your neighbor, let him die. Let him consign me. Oh, he has not seen. Let him die. You just look upon pain, wrong, injustice towards your neighbor, unaffected. Let him die. Foolish him. He's a stupid man. Or you learn your neighbor is in trouble. You say, good. Yes, it's good for him. It's just good for him. Because your conscience is what? It's dead. If your conscience is alive to God, if your greatest enemy is in problem, and you hear he's in problem, you start crying, thinking of how to rescue him. If your conscience is alive to God, your greatest enemy, your number one enemy, if you hear he's in trouble, and the news reaches you, you burst into crying. How will I rescue? How will I help? You will be the first person to run there to rescue him. You are able to pay evil for evil because your conscience is dead. You are able to hold unforgiveness, offense, because your conscience is dead. Can't you know that as a Christian, your situation could be any foolish thing. Your situation is used to preserve you. That is what God normally uses. It's not joy, it's not pleasure, but situation. God often used to preserve us, to keep us for a new level, to reform us. You are able to come to the synagogue today, because of your situation. It's not out of plenty or joy, full of joy, that you rush here. It is one thing and the other. It's either you come here to give testimony of situation God rescue you, or you are here. Is that not preservation? Is that not reform for better position? Is that not blessing? Our situation is not our enemy, but our friend. Your situation is not your enemy, but your friend. It is your situation that still keep you going with God. There are many of us here today, if you are released and you look here plenty, here abundant joy, God will likely lose you. Strength often come through situation. It is not through joy, enjoyment. Strength often come through what? Situation. Strength. Say, I can do all things through God who strengthen me through situation. Don't ignore your conscience. any time to pray, to talk to God. It is time to look inward, to see whether you are right or you are wrong before you pray. You look inward, whether you are right or wrong before you what? Before you pray. Don't ignore your conscience. Your conscience is the very instrument used by the Holy Spirit to guide you. Tell your neighbor, don't ignore your conscience. Your conscience is the very instrument used by the Holy Spirit to guide you. There must not be anything between you and God if you want effective prayer. Holding offense, such as bitterness, anger, and so forth, are the wall between you and God. Wall. You build wall. God here. You are here. Offense. Because I don't want you to waste your energy in offering prayer. Tell your neighbor, don't waste your energy and effort in prayer. Your conscience should not be ignored. If you ignore your conscience, you are wasting your time. You are wasting your time. This is why any time cannot be the best time for a true man of God to pray for you. God always allotted time. They need correspond power to pray. Correspond power to pray. So any time cannot be the best time. You can't just rush to me and say, man of God, pray for me. This is a tradition today. You rush to your man of God. Man of God, please pray for me. Man of God, in Jesus' name, amen. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. No. Anytime cannot be the best time. Cannot be the best. You know, when Jesus was called to the feast, his brother called him, please, come out. There's a feast. Time to demonstrate, to show the world that you are Messiah. Jesus said, look, anytime cannot be the best time for me, but anytime can be the best time for you to do whatever you want to. But me, I need a corresponding grace before I can do what you ask me to do. He said, no, I'm not going. He said, my time has not yet what? Has not yet come. Why? If you rush to me, now, say, man of God, pray for me. I have to examine my conscience before I pray for you. That is why you can't just rush to me and I will pray. Because I need to go back to my conscience to see, am I in position to pray or I need to do some restitution? Imagine I just moved from outside there and I saw somebody in the pool of blood. Ah, oh my God. I feel it. You know, my conscience is disturbed now. Someone just meet me and say, man of God, pray for me. Ah. When my conscience is not its best, it is when our conscience is in its best, we can pray. When your conscience is at its best, you know, when conscience is at its best, you have nothing to think about, you have nothing to worry about, then you can offer prayer. There's some certain thing you ignore. We don't know. Okay? Like you wake up in the morning, you have nightmare. Serious one. Maybe somebody abuse you or eat you. You just wake up. Oh my God, this is nightmare. This is nightmare. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke it. Whom are you rebuking? When your mind is disturbed, whatever you say at that moment, it will filter through worried. What you need to do is to cancel yourself. To wake up and say, this is nightmare. God, I cancel it in Jesus' name. Thank you. You have to make yourself happy. You have to remember message you have received in the past. That when you are weak, then you are strong. You have to remember this. You have to remember immediately those messages. Yes. Yes. When you come to your senses, because when you lose control, this is what Satan do first, to make you lose control, before make you a disciple. When you lose control, you start misbehaving. Then, if you are not lose control, Satan cannot use you as a disciple or servant. When you lose control, he take you as a disciple and use you. You know, if you are not lose control, you will reason well. But when you lose control, you cannot reason well. Then he take you as a disciple. He cannot use you as an errand boy to anywhere he wants you to go. So that is why he uses offense to make you lose control. Offense is instrument that makes you to lose control. When offense comes, you lose control. Why all this? Why? I don't know why you have lost control. I don't know. Then Satan come. Oh yeah, my disciple, okay. Yes, I do this. You started do the work of Satan. With bitterness in your heart, you lose control. With anger, you lose control. With anger, you lose control. That's when Satan takes us as a disciple. You have to help. Those of you that listen to this message, men of God, don't disturb them. You tempt them a lot. You see a man of God that's sitting down laughing. Man of God, pray for me. You meet a man of God, say, on the way, say, man of God, pray for me. Do you know where man of God is coming from? In the same way, you cannot jump into prayer. You need to pause to examine your conscience. In the same way, man of God too, our own is too serious. We need correspondent power to do anything. Man of God, pray for me. We need to examine our heart before we offer prayer, effective prayer. Because if there is something between us and God, we cannot offer prayer to God. So take this home, and I know you will readdress yourself. You can't just jump to prayer. Okay? This is why you see people, when they want to pray, you see them start from worship. Worship, praises, worship, praises. They are using that to prepare their what? Their hearts. They worship. They are using that to prepare their hearts before going to prayer. Even the Bible says in this war, there will be war, offense. Take heart, I have overcome. That is, take heart me, don't hold offense. There will be offense, but don't hold. Offense will come, let it go. Don't hold it. The word H-O-L-D. Don't hold it. You know, when something comes, if something is passing, and I hold it, it becomes an instrument to use. But when it comes and I allow it to go, this is what the Bible says. In this war, there will be war. There will be offense. That offense will not come, no. there will be offense. But don't hold it. When it comes, it comes. Allow it, let it go. In this world, it is not possible for you and I to live without what? Offense. Don't hold it. Don't hold offense. It will come. Let it go. So this is why you have to examine yourself. Don't ignore your conscience. Your conscience is the very instrument used to guide you by the Holy Spirit. Tell your neighbor once again, don't ignore your conscience. It's the very instrument used by the Holy Spirit to guide you. So it's like a ball. The best player today cannot start playing ball without ball on the pitch. And then no ball on the pitch, and you are now started. What are you playing? The same way, Holy Spirit cannot get to you without your conscience. This is why the Bible says faith is of man's heart. And only faith pleases God. Faith is of man's heart. Faith is of man what? It's of man heart. That is, it's of man spirit. So please take care of yourself. Take your pain. Today, people look upon pain wrong and injustice towards their neighbor unaffected. Tell your neighbor again. People look upon pain wrong, injustice towards their neighbor. You know, when we say neighbor, your neighbor could be your enemy, could be your friend, could be those who are not share the same faith with you. The Bible says, love them all. But today, because they are not share the same faith with you, when you see them in problem, you ignore, you look other side. Because they are not share the same faith with you. You are a Christian, they are not Christian. Whatever problem they have, you look upon, you look other side. No! You have to rescue, love your neighbor as yourself. If your spirit, I mean your heart, whatever name you call it, your heart, you call it conscience, is alive to Christ, you'll always be there for your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, if your conscience is alive to Christ, you will always be there for your neighbor. Love your neighbor as yourself. So that's why he said, is that? Hey, it's in the hospital. My prayer has answered. What kind of prayer is that? It's in the hospital. No. No. If it's your enemy, the Bible has its backup there. We say, I will set a table before you in the presence of who? If your enemy is not there, the table will be useless. If your enemy is no longer live, and the table is set before you with a century of life on the table, It's good for your enemy to see what you become. What they thought you cannot become. It's good for your enemy to see. They thought you cannot become this, you cannot become that. It is better they see for themselves. That may change them. He win their soul. But all this deadness heart, die, kill, all. Oh, I will set a table before you in the presence of your enemy. On the table, essentials of life, those things you need for life, peace, comfort, I mean, prosperity. Good example of what we are talking about is we here today. If we begin to examine the heart, the conscience of everyone, and look at the past of our conscience, at least 50 to 40% that are here today ever thought they would come here. You have a different impression about TB Joshua. You stand opposition about TB Joshua in the past. But today, you are alive to see that it's your friend. It's not your enemy. If you have died, then will you be able to say this? If I have died then, will I be here today? No. Why? I will set a table before you in the presence of your enemy. Now, the way out. Ask me the way out for you. I want to hear your voice. Pray for your enemy. I repeat again, ask me again. Pray for your enemy. Prayer from your heart, not from your lips. From your heart. Down your heart. Ask me again. Pray for your enemy. So if you choose the path of praying for your enemy, you have a great relief. Because you are running to defeat your enemy, to overcome your enemy, it has taken you to many places. Spiritually, physically, morally, financially, you spend a lot of money. It takes you sleepless nights, fear, anxiety, pressure. Every bad thing that happened to you, when you have nightmare, you attribute it to your enemy. The pain you are going through is not your enemy that is going through it. It's you that is going through the pain. Why can't you ignore your enemy and move forward? Pray for them. You are the one going through the pain. If someone curses you and say, "Hey, I curse you, your leg," and you started walking immediately like this, you are going through the pain. At the same time, you are pursuing him. You are going through the pain. The person that curses you, your leg, you are going through that pain. At the same time, the person that caused you your leg, you are fighting him two battles. You work like this. When you want to pray, say, "God, this man, I curse him. This man, I curse him. Oh, Jesus, I curse him." So when you begin to chase your enemy, you would automatically forget your condition in which you are. Because it's not possible to look two sides. I'm looking here, and at the same time looking here. if I'm looking here, I cannot look here at the same time. So if I'm going through pain that enemy has caused, and I'm going through it, now the pain, and at the same time, I'm pursuing that enemy, that caused it, I will ignore this pain. The pain will be there, but how to take care of myself will be ignored. Why I'm after that? This is why your situation is persistent, continue. The situation that you are supposed to go through within a week, you are on it for the past 1 year because you ignore your condition and you are pushing your enemy. Enemy is something that you should define. I'm here, my enemy. If I now ask for progress and I have that progress, I will meet enemy in that position again. I've left that enemy. The bigger your success, the bigger your enemy. Why are you wasting your time when you know it's a normal life? It's a normal thing, it's a way of life. My trial cannot be your trial because of my position. I will not go through your trial. You go through your trial according to your position. And I will go through my trial according to my position. It is our position that attracts trial. What attracts trial? I can hear you. Eh? Okay, you are in university, second degree. They will not send permanent school teacher to you to come and inspect your job. It's not possible. So they will send a professor or a PhD that can supervise you, not primary school or secondary school. In the same day, your position in life attracts persecution, attract trial. If your position is big, it will attract big trial. If your position is small, it will attract small trial. And you always pray for big position, big blessing. So that big blessing will attract big trial. You don't want trial, you don't want success in life. When people talk about you, when you go here, they say, ah, it's a foolish man. Go there, it's a foolish man. Here, it's a foolish woman. You know, it's a recognition. People that nothing, they ignore. Okay, here. If a president enter here now, you will see, everybody will start looking. That is president. That is attention because of his position. But if you enter, nobody will look at you. They will say, please, go back. They will say, go back. Even Usher will not even allow you to enter. So please, what we are trying to say is that what you are going through should not rule your life. What you are going through does not matter. But what matters, whom you are. It is your situation that subjected you to what you are now today. When you go out there, even in the midst here, little time you see people talking to themselves. You think he has mental problem. It's not mental problem, oh. As a result of he or her situation. You see people walking, laughing. It's not mental. So there are many people on the street today that you think they are mental. They are not mental. It's as a sort of situation. Their situation overwhelming them. And when your situation overwhelms you, you lose control. You become Satan's disciple. Viewers, Wherever you are, listen to me. Don't ignore your conscience. Your conscience is the very instrument used by the Holy Spirit to guide you, to hear your prayer. Can't you hear what the Bible says in the book of Matthew? Blessed are the pure in heart. They shall walk. Say it again. I can hear you. Think about that. Blessed are the pure in heart. They shall see God. That means our heart is the very instrument used by the Holy Ghost. If you ignore it, you ignore God. If you ignore it, you ignore the Holy Spirit. So, when it is time to pray, it is time to examine yourself first. Time to pray, it's time to what? This is why I gave you, I'm seeing my brother, please bring it. This is why you have this. This is examination. This is to prepare your way. This will help you, your heart, to contact the Holy Spirit. Yes. It will take you out and take you in. There's nothing they say. People that hold it. It's take more of me. It's a way of what? Examine your heart. Take more of me and give me more of you. Me, you are more of yourself. And if you are more of yourself, you are finished. You are losing control. When we are more of ourselves, we have become Satan's servant. Take more of me, give me more of you. Take more of me, give me more of you. More of your faithfulness, your kindness, your goodness, your holiness, your humility. Lord Jesus, take more of me, give me more of you. More of you, more of you. Now, you can know. That's what we call, with our heart, we know Jesus is righteous. With our heart, we know Jesus is blessed, saves, delivers with our hearts. It's not with our eyes. Some people will say, I want to see that healing. I want to see that healing. Even when you see the healing taking place and you see it, but not receive it. At the end, you say, ha. It happened to some people, but it never happened to me. The thing is not working for me. No, it's not with our eyes, with our heart. We know Jesus is righteous. And we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Let someone say, with our heart, we know Jesus is righteous. We know Jesus, he is, saves, blesses, delivers with our hearts. If you have not seen with your heart, you cannot receive from God. With your heart, you receive healing. With your heart, you receive blessing. With your heart, you receive deliverance. Not with our eyes. I saw it, I witnessed it. No, what do this? This side, with our heart, we walk with the Lord. With our heart, we see Lord. With our heart, we praise him. With our heart, we pray. The Bible says Christianity lies in the heart. Let someone say Christianity lies in the heart. Again. That is it. But you don't know this. They say, T.B. Joshua, I want to see with my eye, Kuro Kuro. I want to see. When I set my eye, be he, they will look at, is there any ring in the hand? How many times he called, heal, be healed. Be healed, be healed. Oh, two times. Let me write it down. Two times. Be healed, be healed, be healed. Okay, he turned right. Okay. After be healed, he turned right. Okay, I'll write it. He turned right. When he, okay, look at the way he walked. Okay, this is the way he walked. Let me write it down. After that healing, he laughed. Oh, he write it down. So now, you two, you now say, be healed, be healed. Can you see? These eyes, oh no, no. With our heart, we know Jesus is righteous. So in this case, if with our heart we know Jesus is righteous, it means not all the people that say, Jesus, Jesus, belong to Jesus. Because one can say Jesus, Jesus, not with the heart. So this is so difficult for ignorant to know who is following Jesus. It's so difficult for ignorance today to know the true pastor. So difficult for ignorant to know the true church of God. And 99% of the world are ignorant. You want me to repeat? 99% of the world are ignorance when it comes to things of the Spirit. I repeat again. When it comes to things of the Spirit, heavenly things, 99% are ignorance. How would they know the true church? How would they know the true ministers of God? How did they know the true worshiper? How would they know the true person? How would they know who is who? This is where we find ourselves. We find ourselves in a very big situation. What matters most to God? Your heart. Write it down. What matter most to God? Your heart. Because your heart is the contact point. Write it down. Because your heart is the contact point. You have to guide your heart graciously because your heart is the contact point. Before you call Jesus, take care of your heart first. How do we take our heart? By looking if you are holding offense, such as bitterness, anger, hatred, pain of the power, and so forth. If you do, don't be surprised if the Bible is no longer real for you. Don't be surprised if Bible is no longer what? You understand that? That is, the value is no longer there. Time to read is time to sleep. When you open Bible and you are sleeping, you know something is wrong with you. You just open Bible, you want to read. You start sleeping. Don't be surprised if Bible is no longer value. Read. It will become a literature. If you hold offense, pain of the past, and you open the Bible, you are reading literature, not Bible. If you have pain of the past, bitterness, hatred, somebody offends you, you are not happy, you are disturbed, and you open the Bible, You are reading literature, history, not Bible. When you are reading the Bible, you are reading Holy Spirit. You are looking at yourself and it's looking at you. It's a mirror. Bible is a mirror. When you look through a mirror, you see yourself. But Bible is no longer a mirror to you. Tell your neighbor, the Holy Bible is a mirror. That is M-I-R-R-O-R, mirror. When you take a mirror and look at yourself, look through it, you see yourself, how you look. So the Bible, when you are reading the Bible, you are looking at yourself. But because we usually hold offense all the time. So when you read Bible, why holding offense? The Bible is no longer read, cannot be read. Let me tell you that Bible, holy men were carried along by the Holy Spirit to write the word you see in the Bible. They were carried along to write what you are reading. So when you want to read, you must also be carried along when your heart is free.
We believe you have been inspired by the clip you have just watched. Click here to subscribe to witness more of God's power at work in our generation today and stay up to date with the latest prophecies, deliverances, sermons, and testimonies from the Synagogue Church of All Nations. Emmanuel TV, changing lives, changing nations, and changing the world.